Now, ratio of transmission of belt drive. This is negative slip. This is the ratio N1 by N2 is D2 by D1. Considering slip, this is the epsilon, this value is given. Now, working formula for belt drive. Now, this is we have P is equal to S1 minus S2, S2 is equal to S1 minus P. Substituting this in the value of our S2 in equation 1, we get equation 1 in the other video. I have already done this one is equal to this is the formula. Now, and for S1 we have S1 is equal to sigma into BT. This is the stress into B into T is the area. So and also W is equal to this one. Okay. Now this is the sigma. You can get it in terms of sigma, in terms of P by BT. Okay, this is the working formula. This is a very important formula. Now, the above equation, this equation. The above equation helps to calculate the width of the belt required where P is known from the power transmitted and the belt speed. Mu is known, this is the friction, coefficient of the friction, T is selected and sigma is assumed. Okay, so that much is the remaining portion of the video is this one. Okay.